So good morning. Yesterday we discussed about the analysis and theory part on Porter Governor, and we have also solved one problem on Porter Governor. So today's lecture we will be completely confining to problems only. We'd like to solve three problems on Porter Governor. Let us see the first problem on Porter Governor in today's lecture. So the problem is like this. In a Porter Governor, each of the four arms is 400 mm long. Upper arms are pivoted on the axis of the sleeve, and the lower arms are attached to the sleeve at a distance of 45 mm from the axis of rotation. Each ball has a mass of 8 kg and the load on the sleeve is 60 kg. What will be the equilibrium speeds for the extreme radii of 250 mm and 300 mm of rotation of the governor balls? So this is a straightforward problem. First we have to know how the problem is given, where the arms are connected, upper arms and lower arms are connected. First we'll prepare the diagram for that. Once we get the diagram, then we can solve the problem very easily. So it's a Porter governor with four arms of 400 mm long. So length of arms 400 mm. Then upper arms are pivoted on the axis of the rotation and lower arms are attached to the sleeve at a distance of 45 mm from the axis of rotation. Let me take, this is the axis of rotation. Okay, so here upper arm connected to the axis of rotation and the lower arm is connected to a distance of 45 mm from the axis of rotation, like lower arm connected to a 45 mm distance point. Okay, and upper arm and lower arms are with a length of 400 mm. Then we are aware of it, this is mz and this is mr omega square, and whereas here mz plus or minus F by 2. So if you have a friction, we'll take the friction value, otherwise we'll write the zero value for it. Okay, and you're also aware of this. This is extending this is the eye center. Okay, and what is given? Mass of the ball M is 8 kg. Then load on the sleeve capital M is 60 kg. Then what will be the equilibrium speeds for the two extreme radii of 250 mm and 300 mm? So R1 250 mm. R2 is 300 mm. So this is the data given to us, and we know this angle is theta. So this angle also becomes theta and this angle is beta. Okay, so we have defined various parameters like h, r, this we defined R, and we defined this H, and we defined this is C, B, okay, and this is A. Okay, these are the terminology what we defined in the previous analysis terminology. Same thing I have written here. Okay. Now, let us first find out theta tan theta, so that is this. In the first case, let me write tan theta 1, that is, this is R by H, so that is R1 by H1, and this is given 400, okay, and of course this link is also 400, and this is 45, and what is R1, R1 is given 250, so this is R1 250. So how to get the h is equal to 400 square minus r square, so 400 square minus, that is in this triangle, say this is O, okay, this is A, and let me name this is say B, OAB triangle. In OAB triangle, I want the value of H. So H is nothing but, root over, that is OA square minus AB square. So what is OA? 400. Okay. And AB is R1 250 square. So the same thing I will write here. This is 400 square minus 250 square. So this gives 0.8. Tan theta 1 is equal to 250 by root over 400 square minus 250 square. That gives 0.8. Then your theta 1 can be calculated. Okay, so what is the value of theta 1? Tan inverse 0.8, that you can do. Then we have one more term, k. We defined k is equal to tan beta by tan theta. So if I write k1, tan beta 1 by tan theta 1. So you can see here tan beta, how to calculate tan beta. So this is in this A, say I can call this is M and this is N. So this is beta. So in triangle, this is AMN. In AMN triangle, okay. So tan beta, this is beta. So that is B by A. Tan beta is equal to B by A. So what is this B? Let us see. He has given that R1 is how much it is? 250 minus 45. 250 up to here is 250, and out of this 45 has subtracted, 250 minus 45 by A. So what is A? A is nothing but this height. How to get this? We know this is 400. Okay, then 400 square minus 400 square minus this distance. How much this is? 205 square. 205 square. Okay, so from there we get tan beta, of course tan beta 1, I am writing beta 1, okay, so that is 250 minus 45, so 250 minus 45, and this is 400 minus 205 square, so this gives, so what is the value of B? B is 205, A, that is 400 205 under root, that gives 343.4. This is 343.4. So tan beta 1 is B by A, B is written, and this is 343.4 by This is tan theta 1, already we got 0.8. So by substituting this value, you will get the value of K1 is 0.746. You will get 0.746, okay? So we got tan theta 1, we got tan beta 1, and the ratio tan beta 1 by tan theta 1, we got K1 value, okay? Once we get this value, first my requirement is to find out the corresponding velocity. Okay, we know the equation. What is the equation? M r omega square is equal to tan theta into mz plus mz plus or minus f by 2 into 1 plus k. This is the basic equation which we derived in the last lecture. Mr omega square is equal to tan theta into mz plus or minus f by 2 into 1 by k. So in our case, in this case, f value is not given. So f is 0. That is, the friction value is not given. So this value will become 0. Then we will write Mr omega square is equal to what is tan theta, tan theta 1. Tan theta 1, that is 0.8, m small m 8, 9.81 plus 60 into 9.81 by 2 into 1 plus k, that is 0.746. So I am writing for 1, so mass will not change. Radius is 1, omega 1, tan theta 1, okay, and k1. So I am taking the case 1, that's why I have kept for all the values of suffix values of 1. So if I solve this equation, so m is known. What is m? 8. r1, what is the r1 value? 250, that is 0.25. into omega 1 square. So substitute all the values and get the value of omega 1 square. So if you calculate this omega 1 square, so this will be omega 1 square is equal to 237. Okay. So then you can get omega, that is 2 pi n by 60. Okay, so from there you can get the value of n1 is 147 rpm. So solve this equation and get the omega 1 square. First, from omega 1 square you get omega 1. Then equate omega 1 to 2 pi n1 by 60. Then from there, you get the value of n1, which is 147 rpm. Isn't it? So this is the first part. Here you get how much omega 1. Roughly this will be 237. Omega 1 is root 237. So around 16, not exactly. So 15s are 225. It will be in between 15 and 16. Then equate it to this omega 1 value to 2 pi n1 by 60. Then get the value of n1, which you get 147 rpm. So this is the first part of the problem. Isn't it? This is the part 1. Then part 2 also will be done in a similar lines. Just the values here, we change the values. So we change the values. How the values are going to be changed? Let us see. So let us consider the second case in this problem. So the basic skeleton diagram is as it is. It will not change because the length of the links are same 400, 400, this is 45. Only what the changes we can observe is radius of rotation is changed. So let us see what is the new values. So R is changed to 300 mm. That is R2 is equal to 300 mm. The remaining values are as it is, that is the length of the link and everything. So let us consider once again theta value, beta value for the case 2. So consider theta value, beta value for case 2. Let us see. So now this is theta 2 and this is beta 2. Okay. Then this R value will be R2. So this is R2 omega 2. Then it will be H2. Okay. Then these are all are also changed, like A is A2. So for one previous case I have taken, now I am taking the case 2. So what is given and what to be evaluated, let us see. Like tan theta 2, same as it is, tan theta 2, that is AB by H2. So what is AB now? R2. What is R2? 300. And what is H2? So H2 is equal to 400 square minus this, 400 square minus R2 square. What is R2 square? 300 square. So 300 by 400 square minus 300 square, which gives 1.134. 1.134. Okay, that is the first one. Then what is the value of B? B value, that is B2. Say this is C2, this is B2. So B2 is equal to R2 minus that 45. Then what is R2? R2 is 300 minus 45. So this is 255 mm. This is the B2. Then coming to A2. So how to get the value of A2? This A2 is equal to 400 square minus 400 square minus B2 square. That is 400 square minus B2 square. That is 400 square minus 255 square under root. It gives the value is 308.2. That is A2. Okay, then we get tan beta 2. So tan beta 2 is equal to B2 by A2. So B2 is equal to 255 A2, 308.2. Okay, so then you get tan beta 2. So you get tan beta 2. So after getting tan beta 2, K2, that is tan beta 2 by tan theta 2. So tan beta 2 by tan theta 2 by this 255 by 308.2. Of course, this value you will get directly, you can substitute. And tan theta 2 is 1.134, which gives 0.73. So you got K2. Once you get K2, you can get omega 2, like M R 2 omega 2 square is equal to tan theta 2 so it is M R omega square is equal to tan theta 2 into mg plus mg plus or minus f. Of course, we don't have f value, so f is 0. So this is simply 0, okay, by 2 into 1 plus k 2. So the values are known to us. What is tan theta 2? That is 1.134. Then m, what is the mass given? 8 kg, 9.81. And what is capital M, which is 60 into 9.81 by 2 into 1 plus K2. What is the value of K2? 0.73. Then here M, 8, R2. What is the value of R2? R2 is 2 feet. This is R2. How much it is given R2 in the problem? 300 mm. So that is 0.3 meters. Omega 2 square. So substitute entire data, whichever, whatever is available with us, then we get omega 2 square is 277.6. Then omega 2 is equal to 16.66. So omega 2 can be written as 2 pi nt by 60 is equal to 16.66. Then you can get the value of n2. So the value of n2 is equal to 159.1 rpm. Okay, then finally the range of speed. So range of speed is n2 minus n1. So that is 159.1 minus, what is the previous speed we got? 147. So which gives around 12.1 rpm. So what we did is simply we have changed radius of rotation. Once we change the radius of rotation, your theta value change as well as the beta value change, then k value will change, and once again we substitute, and in this case there is a no friction term is there, so friction is written 0. By simply substituting it, you get n1 and n2 for the corresponding radius of rotation, then the range will be the difference of n2 and n1. So that gives the value of around 12.1 rpm. Let us see in another problem on the same governor, that is a Porter governor. Here the basic equation is same. What is that equation which we have written in the previous case? That is mr omega square is equal to tan theta into mg plus capital mg plus r minus f by 2 into 1 plus k. That equation is same for everywhere, but only the thing is depends upon the problem where the upper arms are connected, where lower arms are connected, you will get the solutions in a different manner. So here in the previous problem, we have seen upper arm is directly connected to the axis of rotation. But in this present problem, it is not directly connected to axis of rotation, but it is connected to an extension link. In that case, how we will find out h and I will solve the problem, let us see in this problem. So the problem is like this. Each arm of a Porter governor is 200 mm long. So this is L is equal to 200 mm long, sorry. And it is hinged at a distance of 40 mm from the axis of rotation. So it is hinged 40 mm from the axis of rotation. So both the top as well as at bottom, it is hinged at 40 mm. So the mass of each ball is 1.5 kg and the sleeve is 25 kg. When the links are at 30 degrees, so initially the links are at 30 degrees to the vertical. The sleeve begins to rise at 260 rpm. So the sleeve begins to rise at 260 rpm. Assuming the frictional force is constant, find the minimum and maximum and minimum speeds of rotation when the inclination of the arms to be the vertical is 45 degrees. So say this is 1, then this is. So this is the problem is given. So first let me draw the sketch as per my requirement, then I will solve the problem. So here this is the axis of rotation. The upper arm is connected to an extension link, and of course lower arms also like an extension link this way. So the arm length is how much? It is 200 mm. So this is radius of rotation, and what is the extension link length? It is 40 mm. This is 40, and as per the definition of H, this is H. H is nothing but the upper arm is extended and intersecting the axis of rotation, that is H. And initially as given, the angle is 30 degrees. So this is 30, and automatically this is also 30. Okay, and this is the data given to us. Let us see how to solve this problem. So the data is given, R, what is the radius of rotation? Let us see, is it given in the problem? R, so distance of 40 mm and the axis of rotation, height is given at a distance, and mass of the balls and angles are given. Okay, now let us see, the speed is given. What is the speed? 260 rpm is given. 260 rpm is given. So we can write R1. Let me write R1. How to get the R1? Let us see. So if I name different points like O, A, say B, say C, D, whatever name you want, you can give, it doesn't matter. This is mz, mr omega square, then here mz plus r minus f by 2, and this we defined I, and we are writing this is B, and this is C, and this is A. Some standard terminology we are following, let us say the same way. So if you look at to find out R1 first, so what is R1? This is DC. So I can write one more point here. Let me call this point is Q. This is ACQ and ABDQ. So R1 is equal to, you can see CQ plus QD. So how to get the CQ first? So CQ, this is 200, this is 30 degrees. So CQ is equal to R sine 30, so sorry, not R, CQ is equal to in triangle ACQ sine 30 or sine theta 1 is, that is CQ by AC. CQ by AC. So I want CQ. CQ is equal to AC sine theta 1. What is AC? 200. 200 sine 30. So sine 30 is 1 by 2. So this becomes 200 into 1 by 2. That is 100 mm. What is it? R1. Not R1. C. CQ. Additionally, 40 mm if you add, then you get R1. That is CQ is equal to 100 plus QD. What is QD? This. That is nothing but AB. QD is AB, which is extension link 40 mm. So 140 mm. So that is the first one. R1 is estimated. R1 is estimated, isn't it? Then I want to find out H. That is, say H1. How to find out H1? Let us see the triangle OCD. In triangle OCD. So if this is 30, automatically this is also 30. So you can write cos 30 is equal to, cos 30 is equal to, or what is it? You can write tan 30, I think. This is tan 30, this side by this side. Okay, you can write tan 30. Tan theta 1 or tan 30 is equal to CD. So this is the triangle OCD. Out of it, CD by DO. What is DO? DO is H1. So this is tan 30 is equal to CD by H1. So H1 is equal to, what is CD? CD is equal to, just now we have calculated CD. That is CQ plus QD, that is R1. So R1 by H1, or H1 is equal to R1 by tan 30. So what is the R1 value? R1 value, just now we have calculated 140 by tan 30. Then you get the value of H1, 243. So I got H1 value, okay, and I got R1 value. These two values I obtained. So at 30 degrees angle, at 30 degrees angle, so sleeve begins to rise. Sleeve begins to rise. So when the sleeve begins to rise, that means sleeve is moving up. When the sleeve is moving up, then what is the friction direction? Friction is downward. He has given at 30 degrees angle, sleeve begins to rise. When the sleeve is lifting up, so it is moving up. When it is moving up, then the friction will be in the downward. Okay. So this is the friction term in the downward. We know that n square is equal to 895 by h. Yesterday we have written this equation into mg into mg. This is downward, friction is downward, so plus f, okay, by mg, mg into mg plus f, okay, by mg, isn't it? So sorry, plus sign is there. You can ask where is k. So k in this case 1. Why? This is tan beta by tan theta is 1. So the basic equation you have, that is 1 plus k, okay, by 2 mg. So 1 plus k, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 to get cancelled. So k term will not be available here. So n square is equal to 895 by h into mg plus f by mg. So what is the h value? H1, we got 243. That is meters, 0.243. Then what is the mass of the ball? 1.5 into 9.81 plus, then what is M? Capital M. Capital M is given 25 into 9.81 plus F by, this is 1.5 into 9.81. So left side is n square. He has given corresponding speed is 260. So 260 square. So n1 square, okay, is equal to 895 by h1 into mg plus f by mg. So I got h1 value here 243, that is in meter, 0.243. n1 value is already given 260. So this is 260. Then your friction f has to be estimated. So if you calculate this friction, you get f is equal to 10 newton. This is the first part of the problem. So you get the value of f. Friction is 10 newton. Okay. So what we did is, for the given data, we have calculated R1 and H1 from the graphical diagram. Then a 30 degrees angle has given, sleeve begins to rise. Then when it rises, the friction will be in the downward, because you know that the friction is in the direction opposite to the movement of the sleeve. Sleeve is moving up, means friction downward. So self weight we take in positive, so this will also become positive. So this n1 square is equal to 895 by h1 into mg plus f by mg. So k is already become 1. So 1 plus k, that will become 1 plus 1, 2, that get cancelled. Yesterday I have given a special case, like when k is equal to 1, like f is equal to 0, like k is equal to 1 and f is equal to 0, one of these cases. See the second part of the problem, okay? So we have seen in the first part, the friction is considered in the downward direction, okay? And we have estimated the value of f. And what is the second part of the problem? Now the angle is 45 degrees. Now the angle is 45 degrees, that is theta. Then what is the minimum speed of rotation when the inclination of the arm with the vertical is 45 degrees? That is the problem, isn't it? So now how to solve this problem? Let us see. Your theta is changed. Earlier theta is 30. Now my theta is Now my theta will become 45. My theta will become 45. This is the only change I get in the problem. So once it theta value change, the entire problem changes. How it changes, let us see. So R is equal to, that is R2. Now I will write, this is R2. So what is R2? This R2 is equal to 200 sine 45. Extension link will not change its length, that is 40 as it is. So 200 sine 45 plus 40, that this gives 181.4 mm. So first I got R2. So once I get R2, now I will find out the value of H2. So what is H2? So you can see by the triangle OCD. So by the triangle OCD, you can write tan theta 2 is calculated as usual in the previous way. So that is R by tan 45. So that is in triangle like this is OCD. So in OCD triangle, okay, so you can see this is tan 45, okay. So tan theta, that is R2 by H2, okay. R H2 is equal to R2 by tan 45. The same thing I have written here. So R2 181.4 and tan 45 is 1, so the H2 becomes 181.4 mm. Then our n value, so after getting the value of H2, okay, I will find out the value of N2 square, isn't it? This is, you know that this is 895, okay, by H2 into Mg plus Mg, okay, plus F by Mg. In this case also K is 1, because both upper arms and lower arms are connected to same extension link. So it is only matter of angle changes. If theta 2 changes to 45, then beta 2 also changes as a 45. So here also becomes K is equal to 1. So now substitute the values. This is 895 H2 0.1814. Then what is M? M is 1.5. into 9.81 plus 1.5 into 9.81 plus, once I take friction positive, once I take friction negative. So this is 10 newtons already obtained by this is 1.5 into 9.81. So I am just considering this, once the sleeve is moving down and once the sleeve is moving up, okay. So now I have taken sleeve is moving down, so by substituting this I get the value of N2 is 300.9 rpm, 300.9 rpm. So everything is known. So n2 square, you get n2 square, which is 90,519. This you get. Then n2 is equal to under root that. So n2 is root of 9519. You get this one. So next, when I consider friction is like moving in the earlier taken, earlier case I have taken moving down. Okay, so moving up and friction is down. Now I will take in the vice versa, that is friction is in the upward, that means it is moving down. In that case, say N3, what we are doing, taking this radius of rotation of say some R2 rotation, once it moves down, once it moves up. So that is when it moves down, friction is upward direction. When it moves up, friction is down. So first I have taken the friction is in the downward direction. That means it is moving up. This is plus. Then I am taking now same equation. Okay, H2, then mg plus mg minus f by mg. Entire equation is same. So no change, only friction, here positive, here it is negative. So that is 895 by 0.184 into 1.5 into 9.81 plus this is this capital M, no, one second, capital M is 25. Capital M is 25. So this is capital M. Into 9.81 minus 10 by 1.5 into 9.81. So here this is capital M, this is capital M. So 25, not 15. This is 25. Okay, substitute this and get the value. This becomes 83,812, or N3 is equal to 289.5 RPM. So this is 300 roughly, and this is 289. Okay, so here what we did, we have calculated new radius of rotation R2, and then we calculated corresponding height H2. Once I considered friction is downward, so this plus F. Once I considered friction is upward, then I considered this is negative. So the variations of the speed is 300 as well as 289 or 290. That means when it is moving up, that is rising, 300 RPM. When it is moving down, then it is 290 RPM. Okay.